Once you've finished your flipbook and it looks perfect, the next step is publishing it. For this step, you have 5 options. Let's start with the default option, public. Your flipbook is automatically set to be published publicly. This will index it in search engines and make it visible to everyone. Now, if you don't want that to happen, you can choose the next option, which is unlisted. You will have to change the settings when publishing your flipbook, but what this will do is essentially make your flipbook invisible to the search engine results. You will not have people finding it randomly via Flipsnack or any other search engine. Now let's move on to the third option, password protected. This option pretty much speaks for itself in the fact that you need a password to access it. The owner of the flipbook is in charge of setting the password and giving it to anyone they find trustworthy. The highest form of privacy with flipbook is to share it with invited people only. This is the highest form of privacy with a flipbook, as the only people that can access it are the people that you personally invite with a special link. Cool fact about this is that if you want to share it with your entire email list, you simply need to upload the list as a CSV. And lastly, you have the option to share your publications only with your readers. What does this mean? These readers become a part of your account, and they will be able to see all the published publications from your account. And for extra security, if we're talking about a company account, all the employees who have a reader role could log in with SSO. This feature is available upon request. And there you have it, all the privacy setting options you have when publishing your flipbook. If you'd like more helpful videos and guides, be sure to check out the rest of our YouTube channel. See you next time.